Hello, this is Turrets and Fan. I'm responding to Apologist117, who's an anonymous Greek Orthodox apologist, responding allegedly to Dr. White. Apologist117 thinks that it's significant that Ignatius refers to the bread of the Eucharist as the flesh of Christ, and accuses Dr. James White of twisting, distorting, and trying to allegorize Ignatius' teaching on the subject. He cites to the letter of the Smyrnians, the 7th chapter of that letter, at the beginning of that chapter, as support for his claim. He starts off by saying that we need to let Ignatius speak for himself, and then he immediately appeals to the fact that Yaroslav Pelikan, a notable historian, thinks that the passage supports the idea of a view of the real presence in the early church. He then rattles off the list of Dr. Pelikan's accomplishments, which are impressive, and makes reference to Pelikan's departure from some form of Lutheranism to Eastern Orthodoxy. Then he jumps to another place in Ignatius' writings, where we see Ignatius calling the Eucharist, quote, the medicine of immortality, quote, the antidote against death, and, quote, everlasting life in Jesus Christ. And that's in his epistle to the Ephesians, the 20th chapter. He then leaves Ignatius again to talk about Dr. Pelikan talking about Irenaeus. Finally, he accuses Dr. White of thinking that he has a better understanding of the Bible than the apostolic fathers did. The problems with this apologist's presentation should be clear. He never engages the arguments in favor of understanding Ignatius' words figuratively. He engages instead in a rather extreme form of the appeal to authority fallacy. He conflates the issues of physical transformation and real presence. He undermines his own argument by appealing to a passage that he himself takes non-literally, and he engages in ad hominem with respect to Dr. White. I'll focus particularly on this passage that he himself takes non-literally. That is the passage from the Epistle to the Ephesians. He doesn't take the medicine of immortality in a literal, physical sense. He takes it spiritually, as he should. That's how Ignatius intended it. Likewise, the antidote against death, he takes that spiritually, not literally, not physically. And everlasting life in Jesus Christ as well, he takes spiritually, not physically, not literally. In other words, he doesn't imagine, and he shouldn't imagine, that Ignatius is saying that eating the Eucharist will cause one never physically to die, that someone will continue to live forever as long as he partakes of the Eucharist, in a physical sense. No, of course Ignatius recognizes that there will be physical death. He's interpreting these things spiritually. But when it comes to the Eucharist being the flesh of Christ, he wants to interpret that physically, literally, and not spiritually, which is just bizarre. And the fact that Ignatius uses figures of speech should be plain. Consider the Epistle to the Ephesians, the 7th chapter. He talks about false teachers, and he says, for they are ravening dogs who bite secretly. Now, you might think that he really literally meant actual and dogs running around biting people with their physical teeth and so forth. But of course that's not what he meant. And if you imagine that he really thought that false teachers were dogs running around, you're as silly as Apologist 117 is for saying that you just take whatever Ignatius says at face value and interpret it literally. The problem is Ignatius, like Scripture, used figures of speech. We have to think about that. We have to consider carefully what the context was, whether or not there's some good reason to take a comment from Ignatius in a literal way, when it could also be reasonably understood in a figurative way. And in this case, we do have good reason to interpret it figuratively, because bread is not flesh. It is not literally flesh. It doesn't have the DNA of flesh. And everyone knows this who's seen the bread. So, in conclusion, Apologist 117's presentation is severely lacking. I don't know whether he understands the issues that divide Eastern Orthodoxy and Reformed theology, but his presentation would not convince anyone who was interested in the text, unless that person is swayed simply by the fact that Yaroslav Pelikan is a great historian. And he is, no doubt, he's very notable. But the appeal to his authority in general does not get us to the question of whether or not he was right, or whether or not he himself actually supports the position that he is being cited for. In other words, he never comes out, there's no quotation here from him saying Ignatius understood this flesh of Christ literally. And even if there was, then we'd have to ask the question, and was Dr. He was a doctor. He was an extremely great academic. Whether or not he was right in saying that, when we carefully consider what Ignatius had to say, we see that there is no good reason to take him literally on this expression. Instead, as we do with his expression, the medicine of immortality, the antidote against death, and everlasting life in Jesus Christ, we interpret him figuratively and spiritually. Thanks for listening. This has been Turtinfan.